Now we'll discuss about the concept of angular impulse. Impulse is a term which you are already familiar, which we have studied at the time of conservation of linear momentum. And we can say for translational motion, total change in linear momentum can be given by impulse. This integration of f dt from 0 to t, force is varying with time, and if force is a constant, can be given as f into delta t also. Similarly, we are going to talk about angular impulse. As for rotational motion of a rigid body, we know that angular momentum is given as I omega, and the net torque applied on a body can be written as rate of change of angular momentum as dl by dt. Here we can write dl is equals to tau dt, which is change in angular momentum due to the application of torque on a body. So we can write, for a constant torque for a time delta t, net change in angular momentum we can write as tau delta t. Similarly, we can write for a time varying torque for a time 0 to t, net change in angular momentum we can write as integration of tau dt from 0 to t. Now in this situation, this tau delta t or integration of tau dt we can write as net change in angular momentum, and as an analogous counterpart of translational motion, this we can write as angular impulse. You just keep in mind, like in translatory motion or just for a given force, if it is applied for a given duration, the product of force and the time for which it is applied is termed as impulse. Similarly, the product of torque and the time for which the torque is applied is given as angular impulse. We are going to take up many applications related to angular impulse, which are extremely helpful for shortening the length of a solution of a complex problem also. We'll take up many examples based on this. In sequence, we'll talk about impulse momentum equation for rotational motion. Like for translational motion, we already studied that initial momentum of system plus minus the impulse imparted is equals to final momentum. Similar to this, we can write for rotational motion, initial angular momentum plus minus rotational impulse or angular impulse can be written as final angular momentum. And here Gr is the impulse for rotational motion, or it can be written as angular impulse, which can be given as tau delta t if torque is constant, or if a variable or time varying torque is applied, it is written as integration of tau dt for the given duration. Like for a simple example, we can say if there is a rigid body which is rotating at an angular speed omega naught, which is the initial angular speed, its angular momentum is I, and say at a point x a force f is applied onto the body, due to which you can say the torque applied will be Fr if R is the perpendicular separation of line of force from the axis of rotation. Then here we can say the torque applied on the body is Fr, and after time t, if angular speed of body changes to omega final. Here we can write that initial angular momentum of body is I omega naught, and you can see the body is rotating in anticlockwise fashion, and the force is applying a torque also in anticlockwise fashion that will angularly accelerate the body. So here we can say initial angular momentum plus the torque applied will be Fr for a time t is equals to final angular momentum I omega final. This is the way how we write angular impulse equation or impulse momentum equation for rotational motion of the body. In this example, we are given a wheel of radius r and moment of inertia I shown in figure is released from rest with a mass m tied to an ideal string wrapped on the wheel. At point O, it is hinged. We are required to find the speed of mass m after time t. Now, in this situation, when we release the system, due to the weight acting on the block, it will fall down and tension will be developed in the string, which will oppose the motion of the block as well as it will provide the angular acceleration in the wheel. Its angular acceleration is alpha, it can be given as A by R. And due to mg as it is falling down, say if its acceleration is A, we can directly write after time t, the speed of this block can be given as u plus at by using the speed equation, as it is given that it was starting from rest, initially no speed was there, so u can be taken as 0, so speed can be written as at. So mainly we are required to find the acceleration of this mass, which can be easily calculated by writing equation of motion. We write equation of motion for this mass and wheel. For mass, we can write as mg minus t is equals to ma. And for this wheel, the only torque acting on it is due to the tension in a string, which can be written as t into r is equals to I alpha, and angular acceleration can be written as a by r. Now, in this situation, this r can be cancelled, this will be squared. And if we add the two results, we'll get mg is equals to m plus I by r square multiplied by a. So, on simplifying, we are getting the acceleration of this falling mass to be mg upon m plus I by r square. Or it can be written as mg r square by mr square plus I. We substitute it here, we'll get the speed of this falling mass after time t, which is mg r square upon mr square plus I multiplied by t. That will be the answer to this problem. We just analyze the alternative solution to same problem. Here we can see that due to the weight of falling mass, it will be falling down. And due to tension, we can see that the wheel will rotate and it will oppose the motion of this falling mass. And initially, as it was released from rest, and after time t, say it will attain some speed v, we just relate the initial and final situation by using impulse equation. So, in solution, let's write impulse equation. We use impulse equation as, for the falling mass, we can write that initial momentum was 0. For time t, its weight was acting in downward direction or in the direction of motion. So, we can write that the impulse is added to it, which is mgt minus the impulse due to tension is acting in opposite direction. So, it can be written as minus tt is equals to the final momentum gained by the block, which is mv. So, this is our equation 1. Similarly, we can write impulse equation for the wheel, which is a moment of inertia I. So, its angular momentum initially was 0. The only torque acting on it is due to the tension, which is tr, which is also acting for a time t. So, we'll add the angular impulse due to the tension, which is trt, must be equal to the angular momentum attained by the wheel, as the block is falling with a speed v. So, tangential speed of all the particles of wheel will also be v, as the string is wrapped around it. So, the angular speed with which the wheel will rotate can be written as v by r, as the tangential speed of particles can be written as r omega. So, the final angular momentum is I omega, which can be written as I v by r. This is our equation 2. in this situation, this R we can take on the right side of equality and let's add the two equations. This TT will get cancelled out, we'll get MGT is equals to M plus I by R square into V. On simplifying, we'll get a speed as MGR square T upon I plus MR square. That will be the answer to our problem. You can verify that the same expression we have obtained by using the equation of motion and finding acceleration of block on the previous slide. And here we are calculating it by using impulse equations.